Janjana Shalakaya Chakshur Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakalpatarupyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're hearing Maharaj Parikshit glorify Vrindavan to his mother, Uttara. And he's describing all the wonderful devotees who are in Vrindavan. And he began by describing the clouds and the rivers and the different trees and creepers, that they're all devotees. And then he's talking about the different birds in Vrindavan. And he says these birds are like great sages. So it's described that they were great sages who were devoted, they were so devoted to Krishna that they came to Vrindavan forest just to become birds and listen to the song of Krishna's flute. And some of the Sridhar Swami, who's a great commentator on Srimad Bhagavatam, he said, even if these sages are self-realized and they're satisfied in themselves, still they should come to Vrindavan and become birds.
Sridhar Swami 是涅波加瓦塔那个了不起的评述家，他说这些圣者们，他们都已经是自我觉悟了的，而且是都已经心满意足了的，但是他们仍然来到了文达文，只是成为自己的鸟类来听 Krishna 的笛音。
Because if they become birds in Vrindavan, then they will achieve what they want, and they can get even more than what they could ever imagine they could get.
因为到了本大文，他们就能如愿以偿，实现他们的长久的夙愿，甚至他们得到了，他们可以得到比他们能够想象的更多的事情。The
birds in Vrindavan should be understood to be so—they're so fortunate because they're able to hear Krishna's flute so much that they're more fortunate than even the bees. The bees were glorified as being great devotees, but these birds are even greater.
These
And when the gopis think about how fortunate these birds are, the gopis feel disappointed. They think, oh, how terrible for us. We don't have such devotion for Krishna. We cannot see Krishna. We cannot hear his flute when he goes to the forest.
他们觉得这些鸟类简直太幸运了，因为我们就不能像那些鸟类一样能够听到Krishna的笛音，在森林当中看到Krishna。We're
not able to give up everything and be like these birds and just climb the branches of the trees. And when we don't see Krishna, we can't stop talking, and we can't and close our eyes like those birds. We're so unfortunate.
这些鸟类它们都那么气绝，它们能够抛下一切，我们就不能像它们一样爬到树梢上来看灰尘的灰尘呢？我们只能。
Yeah, we can't close our eyes and just stop talking the way they do it. So we're really unfortunate. The gopis think like that.
牧牛姑娘们就是这样想的。
Then the gopis glorify the deers, that the foolish deer in the forest, they're so fortunate because they're able to go close to the son of Nanda Maharaj, who's dressed so nicely, and they're able to, when they hear him playing on the flute, the deers, they go close to Krishna.
牧牛姑娘接下来，因为荣耀了文达班的这些鸟鹿儿嘛，那牧牛姑娘说，虽然这些鹿都是愚钝的，但是呢，他们太幸运了，因为他当南达玛哈拉的爱儿，在森林当中吹笛子的时候呢，他穿着漂亮的衣服，这些鹿儿听到之后呢，就会走近他。So
both the male and the female deer, They're able to worship Krishna with great love and affection.
雄鹿和雌鹿都可以满怀爱意的来崇拜 Krishna.
So the deer, they're similar in species. Similar in species to the cows and other creatures who are taken care of by Krishna in the forest. And they're able to go with him. When Krishna brings the cows in the forest, then the deer will also go with them.
这些雄鹿和雌鹿就跟Krishna在森林当中照料的那些生物很类似。 Krishna会带着母牛和其他的生物去森林当中，然后这些鹿儿跟他们都很相似。So
the gopis say, we consider it our great fortune that these deer have responded to the flute, the song of the flute played by Krishna.
他们说，我们觉得我们特别幸运，能够看到，能够听，知道这些鹿儿们，他们是如何对 Krishna 的鼻音做出回应的。And
they're able to go near to Krishna and worship him with all respect.
他们可以走进 Krishna， 满怀敬意的来崇拜他。
The deers worship Krishna very simply. with nothing more than just their loving looks, the loving looks of the deers, how they worship Krishna. They don't have any paraphernalia for their, to do the worship. And the only these looking, just glances at Krishna, are able to satisfy Krishna. Yeah, actually the deer's method of worshipping Krishna was very, very pleasing to Krishna.
事实上, 这些鹿儿们崇拜 Krishna 的方式是非常令 Krishna, 非常令 Krishna 感到心满意足的。
So the deer could see Krishna decorated with nice forest flower garlands and with peacock feathers and the gunja berry in his hair. So even though the deer had taken birth as not intelligent animal, but still they were so fortunate.
虽然这些鹿儿们，他们投生为不那么聪明的动物，但是他们却特别幸运。
Just by hearing Krishna's flute, the deer lose their power to think clearly.
只是听到 Krishna的笛音。 这些鹿儿们就已经失去了能够清晰思考的能力。And
all their senses, internally and externally, all their senses become stunned with the sound of Krishna's flute.
而且Krishna的笛音也使他们内在和外在的感官都已经呆滞了。So
this is the influence of Vrindavan, that even living beings lose their different skills by the sound of Krishna's flute.
这就是文达们的影响，文达们使得这些众生们都是因为由于 Krishna 的音，失去了他们各自的才能。
And when they hear that sound of Krishna's flute, they become so stunned, they become like dumb and immobile living beings. So the deer will, usually they will stay hidden in the forest, but when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then they come out into the open, and they come near Krishna. And when they see the beauty of Krishna, then they become captivated, they become controlled by Cupid.
他们看到Krishna的美丽，都被他深深的吸引住了。他们被丘比特爱神控制了。They can
think of nothing but Krishna.
除了Krishna，他们的脑子里再没有第二个想法。And
they simply look at Krishna with great love and worship him.
他们仅仅是满怀着爱。
And the husbands of the deer, this is a female deer, and the male deer, they also react the same way to the sound of Krishna's flute.
刚才说不到的是雌鹿, 他们的丈夫，也就是雄鹿，也都以同样的方式来对 Krishna 的鼻音做出回应。
So both the female deer and the male deer, they're the most exalted of animals because they have such deep love for Krishna. And they never become proud. They never become proud of their good fortune.
雄鹿和雌鹿，他们都深爱 Krishna， 他们也从来不为自己的好运而感到沾沾自喜。
They always behave like innocent animals.
他们的行为举止永远都是一派天真无知的动物的行为。
So the gopis, they meditate on this devotional service which the deer perform for Krishna.
Gopi 们就这样冥想雄鹿和雌鹿为 Krishna 所做的奉献服务。
The gopis think these deer are very fortunate because they can worship Krishna along with their husbands.
Gopi 们木牛姑娘心想这些雌鹿特别幸运，他们可以和自己的丈夫一起崇拜 Krishna。
But the foolish husbands of the gopis, they cannot tolerate it when their wives worship Krishna.
可是牧牛姑娘那些愚蠢的丈夫却不能容忍他们的妻子来崇拜 Krishna， 没有那么幸运。
So although the gopis are born as human beings, and they're able to understand and act, but still the gopis say, we are unfortunate.
虽然牧牛姑娘投生为人类的形体，而她们可以有智慧，能够明理，能够活动，但是她们却自叹不如鹿儿们幸运。
The gopis say,We're very unfortunate. Although we're born in the family of the cowherd people, which is a good birth, we're very unfortunate.
他们想，我们真是太不幸了。虽然我们可以投生在牧牛郎之家，有一个很好的出生，但是我们却如此不幸。
We're unfortunate because we cannot follow Krishna and listen to his flute.While he wanders in the forest. And we cannot just look at Krishna with wide open eyes, filled with love, and serve him with pleasing looks.
一样大大的睁着眼睛来注视着 Krishna， 以令人愉悦的目光来看他。
And if we, even if a few of us, if we try to do these things, our husbands will complain.
如果我们当中有谁想要这么试图这么做的话，丈夫们立刻就会抱怨。
So the gopis think the husbands of the deer are because only Krishna is important to them. So the attitude of our husbands is just the opposite from them.
对于这些雌鹿来说，只有 Krishna 是他们生活当中最重要的人物，而我们的丈夫跟这些雄鹿的态度却恰恰相反。
Actually, the husbands, the cowherd men, they're actually the most fortunate devotees, and they're devoted to Krishna, but still the gopis.They're subordinate to them because because they're their wives, and they feel shy to reveal their husbands, that their husbands worship Krishna. So because the gopis have husbands, so that when they worship Krishna, they will worship Krishna secretly, just like Krishna is like their lover, and they don't want their husband to know. So this is actually like the highest kind of pure love for Krishna. So after glorifying the deer, now the gopis are going to speak about the cows in Vrindavan. So we heard about the bees, we heard about the birds, and then we heard about the deer, and now we're going to hear about the cows. So the cows, they drink the nectar of the sound of Krishna's flute, which comes out of Krishna's mouth. And the calves, the small calves, when they're drinking the milk from their mother, when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then they stand still, and the milk from their mother is still in their mouth. They don't swallow it. When they hear Krishna's flute, they take Krishna within themselves, and their eyes become filled with tears, and they embrace Krishna in their heart. So the position of the cows in Vrindavan is even higher than the deer in the forest of Vrindavan. Because the cows are considered the most fortunate because Krishna is personally taking care of them. And when the cows hear the sound of Krishna's flute, then it's just like nectar coming from them, which comes from the moon. Yeah, Krishna's face is just like the moon, and there's a flow of nectar coming from the moon. So that sound of Krishna's flute is like that nectar.
So the
calves are some of the calves are newly born, And somehow they also joined their mother and they're busy drinking their mother's milk.
有一些牛犊是新生牛犊，他们也加入他们的母亲的行列。他们当时是在忙着在吮吸奶汁。
But as soon as they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, the calves forget what they're doing, and they simply keep their mother's milk in their mouths without swallowing it.
可是他们一旦听到Krishna动听的笛音的时候，就立刻忘记了自己所做的事情，他们就嘴中口中还衔着牛奶，他们也不往下吞到自己的肚子里。
And for other cows, sometimes the calves are not there. So the cows themselves, they are so absorbed in drinking the nectar of Krishna's flute that they become motion. They just stand still like dead bodies.
有一些母牛们，它们的牛犊并不在身边，所以当它们听到Krishna的笛音的时候，这些甘露就进入到它们的耳孔，它们马上就站在那里呆若木鸡，就像死的动物一样。And
the love for Krishna expands in their heart, and it causes the milk to flow from their udders, and the grass becomes all wet.
他们对Krishna的爱就在他们心中扩展，以至于他们奶囊当中留下的乳汁，地上的青草都变得湿润了。And
they, although they were eating grass, they're not able to chew the grass. The grass was in their mouths, but when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute, they're not able to chew the grass.
尽管他们当时正在吃草，但是Krishna的笛音使得他们停止了咀嚼，这些青草仍然留在他们的口中。So
these cows, they have a very great love of Krishna, and with their eyes, they're always embracing him with their heart.
Tears
come in their eyes.
眼中的泪水都顺着脸颊流淌下来。So
when the gopis hear this description, they say, if the cows are like this, then we gopis, we should be excused for being driven to extremes. But the gopis appreciate the cows. They say that they're the inspiration for us gopis to become more better devotees of Krishna.
当这个姑娘听到这番描述的时候，心想，甚至连母牛们都有这种表现，那么我们的极端的表现也应当得到宽恕原谅。所以，公平们就这样欣赏着母牛。
So when Krishna plays his flute, the different animals in Vrindavan, like the cows and the deer and the bulls, they are all standing in groups at some distance away, and they become captivated by the sound and they stop everything they're doing.
Krishna的音使得文达文的这些动物们，如母牛、鹿儿还有公牛，都远远地站在那里。他们都是成群结队地站在那里。音吸引他们，使得他们都停止了他们的活动。Even
they're chewing food in their mouth, they will stop chewing and they will pick up their ears will stand up and they will become stunned, just as if like they're asleep, or like they become like figures in a painting.
他们虽然在咀嚼着青草，这些鼻音呢，使他们的双耳立刻就竖了起来，他们马上就站在那里，然后推着木屐，他们好像就像画中的动物。So
the gopis are talking. They said, "Here's this is wonderful. Just hear this." They say, when the bulls and the deer and the cows, when they hear the flute, the sound of the flute, they feel the urge to go to Krishna. And they
has the urge, the 然后他们就有一种冲动，想要走到 Krishna 之前。
And they come from far away, and they will stand by beside Krishna.
他们就从远远的地方走进 Krishna, 就站在 Krishna 身边。
And they forget about the grass which was in their mouth that they were eating. They just forget about it.
甚至连自己正在吃的青草都忘记了，还在他们口中。So
it either stays there or else it falls to the ground.
所以这些青草或者还在还留在衔在他们口中，或者有的都掉在了地上。And
their ears stand up, their ears become erect, and the animals become they just stay still, just like they're in a painting.
他们的耳朵立刻竖了起来，他们呆呆地站在那里，好像画中的动物。So
they've got so much love for Krishna that they lose all their power to think and to do activities.
他们对 Krishna 的爱使得他们失去了思考力，失去了行动力。Another
way to understand what happens is, at first, the cows hear Krishna's flute from a distance.
另外一种理解的方式是，一开始这些母牛们都是在远处远远的听到Krishna的笛音。Alright,
so it's because it's at a distance, it's not very clear.
因为距离远，所以笛音也听得不那么清晰。
But just that faint sound is enough to capture their heart and to agitate their minds. And when the animals of Vrindavan, when they hear the sound of Krishna's flute more clearly, then they feel, they fear that death might come and separate them from Krishna. So to prevent themselves from hearing any more, they lift their front legs and try to cover the holes of their ears. And when that fails to stop the sound, they come closer to Krishna, and they have blades of grass in their mouth, just like a sign of humble surrender.
这种做法也无法阻止笛音进入他们的耳孔的时候，他们就走进Krishna，口中衔着青草，就好像一种谦卑的臣服的表示。
And when that also fails to stop Krishna from playing the flute, then they all become stunned. They cannot move.
如果这种做法也不能阻止Krishna继续吹奏他的笛子的话，这些动物们他们就只能呆呆地站在那里一动不动。
Okay, then more people are going to be described. Now the gopis are going to describe, they talked about the different animals in the forest of Vrindavan. Now they're going to speak about some of the people in Vrindavan.
前面呢，牛姑娘在描述的是Vrindavan的动物们，接下来他们描述了Vrindavan的人类。And
they're in Vrindavan, there's these aborigine women, and they become disturbed by lust when they see the grass marked with the red from the lotus feet of Krishna.
那么他们有一些部落的女郎们，她们看到地上的青草标着有 Krishna 的莲花族留下的红色的印记的时候，色欲立刻就油然而生。
So this red powder, it was originally on the breasts of the girlfriends, the lovers of Lord Krishna.
这些红粉是来自于 Krishna 女朋友乳房上的红粉。
So the aborigine women, they take this red powder and they smear it on their faces and on their breasts. And when they do that, they feel very satisfied and they get free of all anxiety.
这些部落女郎们从地上拾起这些红粉，将它们抹在自己的脸颊和胸乳上，这种方式使他们都感到了心满意足，他们就不再感到焦灼的感受。
So these ladies, the aborigine ladies, they live in the forest.
这些部落女郎们，她们的居所是在Vrindavan的森林。
There's one tribe who live in the forest in Vrindavan. They're called Pulindas, and there's others also known as Sabaras.
一个部落名字叫普林达，另外一个部落叫 Sabara。But
there are many other tribes also, and these people, of course, the Pulinda women, they're considered very low class because they're just aborigines, but they're fully satisfied when they smear themselves with that red dust from the feet of Krishna.
除了这两个部落，还有其他的部落，但是普林达仍然是，因为他们都是游牧，他们都是就是不开化的，但是仍然他们从地上拾起这些红粉的时候，他们的色欲心满意足了。
Yeah, when they put that red powder on their breasts and on their faces, then they give up, feel lusty. They don't feel lust anymore. They're satisfied.
就是当他们把这些红粉，朱砂粉抹到自己的脸颊和自己的胸乳上的时候，他们就感到他们的 炽热的色欲之火不那么熊熊燃烧了。
So this kumkum is usually found on the breasts of women. So it's surprising that it could be found on the grass.
Kumkum, 朱砂粉通常是在妇女的胸乳上可以找到的，但是在地上竟然也草丛当中也有这种朱砂粉，是非常令人惊讶的。
So the gopis, they don't explain the reason they don't say directly where this powder comes from, but everybody knows it must have come from the breasts of the gopis.
牧牛姑娘并没有解释接朱砂粉是来自哪里，但是众所周知的是，它们是来自于 gopi 身上。
Some gopis are being attracted to the sankirtan, the chanting of the names of Krishna and the song of Krishna's flute. They allowed themselves to be seduced.
有一些牧牛姑娘被高声的齐颂 Krishna 的圣名和 Krishna 的鼻音所吸引，所以他们就允许自己被 Krishna 所吸引，就跟随着 Krishna。
So that powder which was on their breasts, it got onto the lotus feet of Krishna, and when Krishna would walk through the forest, then that powder would be left on the grass everywhere.
所以这些朱砂粉就从他们的胸乳掉到了 Krishna 的莲花足上，所以每当 Krishna 在森林当中行走的时候，就留在了滚打滚的草丛里。
And when the Aborigine women, they were looking for wood, and they're going through the forest looking for wood and different wild herbs, when they came to the same part of the forest, they discovered this, could see all this red powder on the grass and on the stones.
So these tribal women, they were looking for wood, or looking for these herbs, and when they跟进的时候，他们在森林当中就发现了留在草丛当中和石头上的朱砂粉。
So how did it happen that these tribal women were so lusty?
为什么这些部落女郎这么色欲冲天呢？
So when they saw the kumkum, the red powder on the ground, it reminded them first. It reminded them of Krishna.And then it reminded them of his intimate affairs with the gopis.
Because they saw the ground, the 这些朱砂粉 kumkum 粉，就使他们联想到了 Krishna， 也联想到了 Krishna 跟牧牛姑娘之间的亲密的爱恋逍遥。
So this would agitate the minds of these Aborigine women.
就使得这些部落女郎的心意立刻就躁动不安起来。
But then how did they get free of that agitation? Simply by picking up the red powder and putting it on their faces and on their breasts.
他们怎么才能让自己的这种情欲之火平息下来呢？只是拾起地上的朱砂粉，抹在自己的脸上和抹在自己的胸脯上。
Yeah, because when they did this, they felt completely satisfied.
这样，之后他们就感到彻底的心满意足了。
But the gopis, when they hear this, they feel sorry. They think we will never be so satisfied just by that.
牧牛姑娘听到了这些描述之后，就感到很难过。她们觉得她们自己也是不能以这种方式得到满足的。
Yeah, the kumkum becomes more beautiful by being smeared on the breasts of Krishna's gopis.
朱砂粉被抹到了，牧牛姑娘的胸上的时候，就显得更加的美丽。
And it becomes very effulgent in contact with Krishna's lotus feet.
朱砂粉和 Krishna 莲花足接触之后就会熠熠发光。
So these Aborigine ladies, normally they're not very beautiful and they don't have any effulgence, but when they decorate their bodies with the red powder, then they become beautiful and they become effulgent.
通常来说呢，这些部落女郎们相貌并不美丽，而且也没有那么多的光泽。然而，当她们把朱砂粉抹在自己身上的时候，她们就变得异常美丽，并也发起光，并也放射着光芒了。
The gopis, they say, we're unfortunate. We cannot become such good devotees as these aborigine women.
牧奴姑娘们就自叹弗如，觉得自己并不如这些部落女郎们那么幸运。
Because the gopis, they're always feeling the separation from Krishna. So they always think that everyone else must also be suffering the same way.
这个姑娘们时时刻刻的都在跟 Krishna 的分离之火当中煎熬着，她们也认为别人跟她们一样，也是在分离之火当中受到煎熬。
So these aborigine women there must also be feeling the pain of separation from Krishna.
她们觉得这些部落女郎们也在感受着跟 Krishna 的分离，受着煎熬。
So the limbs of the bodies of these ladies was covered with the red powder, so they looked exactly like the same color as the lotus feet of Krishna.
部落女郎的四肢都涂上了这些朱砂粉，她们的这个肤色就像 Krishna 的莲花足的颜色一样。
So when the gopis saw these aborigine ladies, they remembered how, for Krishna's pleasure, they had decorated their breasts with that same red powder. Yeah, because the color of that kumkum, that red powder, the color of it was just like the color of Krishna's lotus feet. So the gopis liked to use it. And the wonderful music of Krishna's flute would attract the gopis into the forest, and they would wander around looking for Krishna.
Krishna 的笛音就吸引了牧牛姑娘，也要进入森林当中。他们也在森林当中四处的漫游，去寻找 Krishna.
But when they would wander in the forest, they couldn't find him anywhere.And then they would just roll on the ground and feeling the separation from Krishna, they would roll on the ground, and so they would cover the grass with that red powder from their breasts. So then the aborigine women, they would come and they would see the red powder and they would remember Krishna and they would remember his dealings with the gopis.
So the 部落女郎们来到这个地方的时候，就见到了地上的草丛，又看到了朱砂粉。立刻联想起了 Krishna， 也联想起了 Krishna 和牧牛姑娘之间的爱情。
So thinking about the great love which the gopis have for Krishna, and then remembering about the powder, the kumkum that is coming from the bodies of the gopis, the tribal ladies, the aboriginal ladies would pick it up and put it on their own faces and on their bodies.
对 Krishna 的伟大的爱，就是使得这些牧牛就是部落女郎们， 就联想起了 Gopi 们，联想起了 Krishna， 好，他们就立刻从地上也都拿起了朱砂粉，抹到了自己的身上。
And because they were lusty, so they would smear that red powder on their own breasts.
因为部落女郎内心充斥着色欲的火焰，所以他们也会把这些朱砂粉抹到自己住的地方的草上。
But then they would wipe it off, and they would just throw it away.
然后他们又把它抹掉，然后扔掉。
Because it would cause them a lot of intense pain. And they were already disturbed just by seeing the powder. And when they touched it, their minds became more agitated.
Because they were already disturbed just by seeing the powder. And when they touched it, their minds became more agitated. Because they were already disturbed just by seeing the powder. And when they touched it, their minds became more agitated. Because they were already disturbed just by seeing the powder. And when they touched it,他们就更加的躁动不安起来。
And when they smeared it on their faces and on their breasts, the pain was so great that they had to wipe it off quickly.
当他们把这些朱砂粉抹到自己的脸颊和胸脯上的时候，他们感到了更加痛苦，所以他们只好又把朱砂粉给抹掉。
They were afraid that other people may come and use it, and they would get trouble also, like they did.
他们担心别人也会来使用这些朱砂粉，也会像他们那样受到了不好的影响。
So the gopis would complain. They say, just like these tribal women, we are.Most unfortunate.
Gopi 们就开始抱怨，说就像这些部落女郎那样，我们也是非常不幸的。
Yeah, we're put in an ocean of intolerable pain.
我们被投掷到一个无法容忍的痛苦之洋当中。
Just see how unlucky we Gopis are.
看看我们这些牧牛姑娘是多么不幸啊！
Just by touching that cosmetic, that powder from our bodies, people feel such misery, and they throw the stuff away to protect themselves.
仅仅是因为触碰到了来自我们身上的这些化妆品，就使得别人有这么多的痛苦。使得他们立刻就把这些化妆品扔得远远的，来保护他们自己。
Okay. So sometimes Krishna would go to a faraway place just to see the beauty of the forest.
有时候 Krishna 会去遥远的地方。仅仅是为了去观赏森林的美景。
So the other cowherd boys, they would run to go with Krishna. They would want to be with Krishna.
其他的牧牛童们都会纷纷的在 Krishna 身后追赶他，跟他在一起。
And one cowherd boy would say to the other, "I will be the first to run and touch Krishna."
其中一个牧牛童会对另外一个牧牛童说。我会是第一个追到 Krishna 触碰到他的人。
And the other cowherd boy would say, "No, I will be the first to touch Krishna."
另外一个牧牛童就会说，不是你，是我是第一个碰到 Krishna 的。
So they enjoyed their life was enjoyable just by touching Krishna.
所以他们的生活就是这样，仅仅因为触碰到 Krishna 就变得其乐融融。
So the cowherd boys, they're greater devotees than these women, obviously, the forest women, the Aborigine women. These cowherd boys are much higher devotees.
So these 牧牛童们比起那些部落女郎来说是更加伟大的奉献者，地位要高。
So we're going to hear about the cowherd boys these gopis, how they're such great devotees.
我们接下来将要听到的是这些牧牛童们他们的伟大地位。
So very early in the morning, Krishna's eager to enjoy the day's pastimes, things like killing Agasura and taking lunch in the forest.
一大清早 ，Krishna 就渴望去享受他白天的小时光，从杀死阿巴苏惹，然后在森林当中去荣耀午餐。
So Krishna would call all of his friends. He had a buffalo horn, and he'd blow his buffalo horn. And when he blew his buffalo horn, all of his friends would come out of their houses by the thousands.
Krishna 会用他的水牛角来呼唤母牛童，母牛童们就纷纷从家中走过来，他们的数目是成千上万的。
And he didn't just have millions of cows, he had billions of cows and calves, and they all set out to the forest. And they were decorated with the different things from the forest, the fruits and the twigs.And other items.
他们身上都是装饰着森林当中的物品，例如水果，还有嫩枝等等。
And some are playing on the flute, and other people are blowing their horns, and some are imitating animals.
有些牧牛童吹着笛子，有些吹着号角，还有的在模仿着动物的动作。
So they were playing different games simply for Krishna's enjoyment. They had a chance to touch Krishna, and that gave them the greatest happiness.
They had a chance to touch Krishna, and that gave them the greatest happiness.
They would compete to see who could be the first to touch Krishna. And sometimes Krishna was so attracted to the forest that he would want to go alone to just explore the forest on his own.
深深地吸引着，他就想独自一人去探险。
But he was so attached to the cowherd boys and to these friends, he was so attached to them that he could only leave them for a little while.
他对牧牛童却深深地依附他们，使得他只能小会儿的时间离开他们。
And then the boys would run after Krishna. When they saw Krishna had gone on his own, they would run after him and try to follow him. If the cowherd boys, they had to be with Krishna, right with Krishna, and able to touch him, but otherwise they were not satisfied.
朋友，他们只想跟 Krishna 在一起，只想，跟他有这种身体上的接触。不是这样的话，他们就不会满足。
Okay, so we'll stop here today.
好，我们听课部分就讲到这里。谢谢你们看见问题。
Are there any questions?
Yes. 第一个问题是 Oppo 5P， 怎样才能恢复对 Krishna 的爱？谁能赐予我们这种爱？每天做什么？怎么觉得对 Krishna 的描述像神话一样呢？ How can we revive our love for Krishna? And who can bestow this kind of love? What should we do? What should be our daily activity? And why I feel that the description of Krishna is like a myth. A fairy tale.
Why do you feel it's like a fairy tale? Because you're a conditioned soul. You're trying to understand Krishna's pastimes with your material mind and senses. So what was the first question?
And how can we revive our Krishna, love for Krishna, Krishna prema?
Yes, you're right. We have to revive it. It's in us. And we have to revive it. And the process to revive it is by hearing about Krishna. Just like if you get hit on the head and you lose your memory, how do you get your memory back? You have to hear. You have to be introduced. This is your family. This is your home, this is your friends, and then gradually you get your memory back. So the same way, we have to hear about Krishna. We have to hear, Krishna is our worshipable Lord. He is the Supreme Lord. We are His servants. We have to hear. That's why we're having these classes every day, every morning, every evening, all day. We try to speak about Krishna. We want to remember Krishna, and then gradually we'll start to remember.
What should we do every day?
We should do sadhana bhakti. Every day you have to wake up and chant Hare Krishna, and you have to worship Krishna and hear about Krishna. You have to offer your food to Krishna. You have to offer obeisances to Krishna. You have to do sadhana bhakti. This is the process to awaken your love for Krishna.
The next one?
Yeah.
第二个, Krishna 的生日, continue the question. Krishna 生日, 爸爸生日, 连着, 由于家庭工作, 能参加一次, 选择哪个合适呢, 比较现实? We'll have Janmashtami and Srila Prabhupada Vyasa Puja. It's continue with one another. So I can only participate with one festival. Which one should I choose? And which one's the practical?
What? She cannot take part in Janmashtami and Prabhupada's Vyasa Puja?
Because she, this devotee has her job and her family to take care, so she can only choose to whether to participate in the celebration of Janmashtami or to choose to participate in the Srila Prabhupada Vyasa Puja day. So she's wondering which one should she choose.
So Prabhupada Vyasa Puja.
那您就选择参加师父帕帕的的生日。对，我们比较重视 Krishna 生日，对帕帕生日没有比 Krishna 生日那么重视，所以在帕帕生日那天不组织联谊可以吗？这种心态没问题吧？ Continue the question. We pay more attention to Janmashtami and the less importance to Srila Prabhupada Vyasa Puja. Therefore, we do not organize the celebration in Prabhupada Vyasa Puja day. Is that all right? Is this a mood all right?
No, not really.
这个不好，有问题。
The
next one?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay. 下一个是 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj.Please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. Thank you very much for the knowledge you are giving us, Christian. Lord Balarama also had his gopis. Could you tell us more about that? 这个问题来自于 Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj. 能接受我谦卑顶拜，荣耀归于 Srila Prabhupada. 感谢您给予我们的支持。问题是，主巴拉拉玛也有自己的牧牛姑娘，您能不能给我们讲一下这一方面的呢
？Well, no difference. Just like Krishna has his gopis, Balaram has his gopis. So Krishna does Rasa Lila. Balaram also has Rasa Lila with his gopis.
没有区别 ，Krishna 和 Balarama 都有 gopi 牧牛姑娘，就像 Krishna 有 Rasa 之舞。Balarama 也有 Rasa 之舞。
Yeah. You read Krishna book, you can read about Balaram with his gopis when Balaram went back to Vrindavan. After Krishna and Balaram left Vrindavan, they went to Dwarka. First they went to Mathura, then they went to Dwarka. Then after some time, Balaram came back to see the gopis and to see Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda.So at that time, Krishna was with, Balaram was with the gopis, with his gopis.
您可以阅读 Krishna 快乐的全员，描述当 Krishna 和 Balarama 他们离开文达，当然逐渐去马图拉，就去了 Dwarka。过一段时间， Balarama 又都回来见 Gopi 见 Nanda 大姬要收的妈妈，所以 Krishna Balarama 就和自己的 Gopi 们共舞。
So you can read those stories. Lord Balaram visits Vrindavan.
您可以阅读有关于 Balarama 在 Vrindavan 的这些逍遥时光。
Yeah, go ahead.
Krishna Kumar Devadasi, 顶拜顾的莲花组，问每天抽打信一百遍是严格的自我批评吗？如果是平时对自己要求高，睡眠时身体也不易放松的奉献者，该如何不打心引，让自己处在平和之中呢 ？Krishna Kumar, obeisance to the lotus feet of Guru. Can you explain what does it mean that we should whip our mind 100 times each day? Does that mean that we should we should criticize ourselves very strictly?
Well, yes, that's one way. You can criticize yourself very strictly. Be very critical of yourself. That's good.
是的，这是一种 方式。非常严格的自我批评，这是好的。
Get your mind to do the things it doesn't want to do. Like, if the mind doesn't want to chant, you have to chant. The mind doesn't want to hear about Krishna, you have to hear about Krishna.
心意就是不讲念诵，你就得让心意念诵。心意就是不讲聆听 Krishna， 你就得让心意聆听 Krishna。
Like this, this is how you deal with the mind.
就以这种方式来对付心意。
The mind wants to eat and sleep more, so we have to reduce that.
心意想吃的更多，睡的更多，我们必须要减少吃和睡。
Okay.
如果 if we have a high respect, we have high standard for ourselves. For those devotees who have very high standard for themselves and their body cannot easily relax. So how can they whip their mind?Situated in the shanta, in the very peaceful state.
Well, you become peaceful state when you fix your mind on Krishna.
您把心意专注于 Krishna, 心意就会平和了。
When you start to chant the holy name with proper attention and with feeling from the heart, then you'll feel peace of mind.
如果你以正确的专注来唱诵哈利路亚呢，然后以正确的以情感，内心怀着情感去念诵哈利路亚呢，就会感到内心的平和。
Yeah.
The next one is from Lalita Kumari. Mumbai Maharaj. Balaram 和 Krishna 每天去放牛，被称为牧牛童。Radha 牧牛姑娘却从未去放牛，为什么称为牧牛姑娘？有什么消失光吗？感谢 Guru 的答疑也解惑。Obeisances to Guru's lotus feet. Because Balaram and Krishna, they go to the forest to take care of the cow. Therefore, they are called the cow cow. But Radha and Gopis, they have never go to the forest to take care of the cow. Why do they call Gopi? Are there any pastimes?
The gopis are also taking care of the cows. When the cows come back, the gopis, they milk the cows and they have to cook the milk and make the milk into yogurt and butter and ghee. And they also clean up because the cows, they stay at night. They come back from the forest or they come back. So the gopis, they have to clean up. They have to collect all the gobar and they have to make...cow dung patties, because they use that to cook. So they're very busy, they have a lot of things to do, and it's all service for the cows.
牧牛姑娘呢也很忙，照顾这些母牛。母牛从森林当中回来之后，他们要给牛挤奶，要煮牛奶，做酸奶。黄油，奶油，还要给这个，还要清洁牛舍，还要清洁牛粪，然后把这个牛粪做成牛粪饼来煮饭，所以他们很忙着来服务这个牛。
So that's why they're called gopis.
由于这个原因，所以他们有 gopi 牧牛姑娘之称。
Their whole business is taking care of the cows. Everyone's taking care of the cows, the men and the women.
他们的这个生活都是围绕着牛、母牛转的，无论男女女，他们的生活都是围绕着牛转的，忙着照顾牛。
Sometimes the cow will get pregnant, and she'll deliver a calf. So then the cow gets pregnant, they'll keep her back. They won't go to the forest. when the gopis have to be there, they have to help the cow when the cow is delivering the calf.
当母牛怀孕就要生牛犊的时候，这时候就不能去森林，牧牛姑娘就得在家照料这些怀孕的母牛，帮助母牛生产。
Okay.
下一个，当体鱼也红，顶拜孤乳。我们有分离之情，分离之苦，会彼此怨恨，怎么升级为更深的爱呢？顽固，Basis Guru, we also have that feeling of separation, but the bigness arising from this kind of separation will cause hatred and resentfulness from our heart. How can we elevate this kind of feeling to more deeper love? Thank you, Guru.
Who's asking this?
Devotees called Shen Yang Yu Ye Hong.
Oh, Yu Ye Hong. Well.We have to understand pure love is all centered on Krishna. And we're in the company of, when we're in the company of materialistic people, then it's difficult for us to remember Krishna.
那些物质主义者为伴的时候，就很难讲起 Krishna。
We have to keep Krishna in the heart, just like we heard about the gopis. They worship Krishna like he's a paramour, like he's a secret lover.
我们要把 Krishna 放在我们的内心深处。就像牧牛姑娘，她们崇拜的方式就好像是把克什纳当成他们的情人那样的，来放在自己的内心深处来崇拜。
So we have to feel this relationship with Krishna in that way that it's confidential, it's secret.
所以我们对 Krishna 有这样的感受，这种非常秘而不宣的一种秘密的崇拜 Krishna 的方法。
Yeah. What is actually the question again? Let me hear.
The question is that because sometimes we also have that kind of.Because we also feel the feeling of separation, and that will cause each other hatred.
That will cause each other what?
Yeah. Hatred with hate each other.
Hate?
Yes.
Hate who?
And the two people, when they are separated with each other,And they will feel very painful. And following that kind of painfulness, they will have that feeling of resentfulness for each other, complain for each other.
Well, usually being separate from people thatit increases our affection for them, not hatred for them. But when we're separate from people, then we become more appreciative of them. When we're with them, we don't appreciate so much, but when we're separate from them, then we appreciate them more.
通常的情形是，当人两个人分开的时候，就会他们会更加欣赏对方。通常的情况是，当两个人在一起的时候，就不那么欣赏对方了。Shruti Rupa Devadasi, Hare Krishna Devadasi Guru,
Hare Krishna.
Yes.
Krishna. 刚刚提问的是，刚刚启迪的沈阳的奉献者，他叫 Yogala Kishore. Kishore. 他是指他和他亲人的这种关系，长久的这种又想念又怨恨的这种关系。是分离的，怎么跟 Krishna 的知觉连在一起？
跟亲人是指的是什么样的亲人？
母亲有一些，对，
哦，
有一些解不开的，
哦，
结。
Yes. This newly initiated devotee, you can be sure.Because she had some not comfy in her heart with her mother. For a long time, she wondered how can she resolve that of difficult feeling in Krishna consciousness or connect that kind of feeling with Krishna consciousness.
Well, difficult to think how to connect it to Krishna consciousness, but simply think of your mother, that she's also a devotee, a part and parcel of Krishna, that she's part and parcel of Lord Krishna. She's also a spirit soul. So as spirit souls,Your karma has brought you together.
This is very hard to connect with Krishna. You should think of your mother as a devotee. She is also a devotee, Krishna's possession. She is also a soul. Due to the karma of the relationship, the two are together. She had difficult times with her mother, some difficult time, and they are separated. They do not live together for a long time. And because they have some dealings, some resentment, not unpleasant dealings with each other, therefore there are harbor some hatred or some resentment, complaint for each other, for some affairs.
Yes, I know. Sometimes people feel that we have these problems together. But we have to understand somehow, you know, that this is our karma, that somehow due to our karma we're put together. And even though the relationship is not very nice, we have to be tolerant.
住在了我们自己的业报，由于这个业报的关系呢，那我们就跟自己的母亲呢，就有了这种母女关系，然后我们在一起，然后有的时候母女关系不好，我们也要容忍。
So you can think Krishna's training put you in this situation just to train you in tolerance.
您可以这样考虑这个问题，就是 Krishna。把您呢置于这种境况，就是要磨练，来训练，您的耐力、容忍的心。
Everything is the arrangement of Krishna.
一切都是 Krishna 的安排，一种历练。
So you could think, You may think that better to just stay away and avoid the relationship and pretend it doesn't exist. Or you can tolerate and just simply learn to live with the difficulties which are there. If you're able to just simply stay away and you don't care about your mother and just give up the relationship, then okay, your mother is the Vedas. You can take shelter. See, the Vedas, the scriptures, like a mother. There are seven different mothers. So one mother is the bodily mother, but there's other mothers. There's seven different mothers, so you can take shelter of another mother.
放弃这种关系，因为她虽然是您的亲生母亲，但是按照韦达经和经典训示说有七位母亲，其中一个是亲生母亲，除此之外还有另外六位，一共七位母亲，那么您可以托庇于另外的别的母亲。
And the cow, they are also mothers.
地球也是母亲，母牛也是母亲。
So, it's up to you to decide. If you don't need the relationship, if the relationship is so trouble, then better to just stay away, you know, and just forget it, you know.
这就取决您自己了。如果这个麻烦太麻烦了的话，那您就可以离得远远的，然后把这个关系就忘掉，彻底的忘记它。
Just like we know some people, they get married and they live together, but then they don't get along well together, so they separate, they just divorce or something. They don't want to continue the relationship.
就好像，就比如说也有婚姻的时候呢，两个人处不到一起，处不来，然后他们就选择分居，或者是选择离婚，然后就停止这段关系了。
It's not very good, but if they live together, it can be worse.
虽然不好，但是如果在一起，可能更糟糕。 下一个，出题如何？There are a lot of questions. Hare Krishna， 请代咕噜老师们请教：咕噜，我在学习梵文的过程中，因为没有明显进步，常常沮丧失落，发音的时候常常把不会的音节直接含糊过去。那咕噜，既然梵文是超然灵性的，是否这是 Krishna 想让这样给笨拙的我看到自己身上急躁急功近利，对咕噜对圣典没有100%信心呢？我现在每天向昆士罗咕噜祈祷，除了走向觉悟真理道，别无选择，请咕噜训示我怎么培养安忍、耐心、专注、稳定和自信的品质呢？感恩咕噜老师们。 There are two parts. The first one is that during the course of learning the Sanskrit, there's no apparent progress. I feel depressed. Disappointed, especially the pronunciation, sometimes just blurry. The question is that since the Sanskrit is transcendental, is that the Krishna arranged to use this course let me see my fault in my heart, in my myself. I'm very when I do those things, I want to see the result very quickly, and I don't have a 100% faith in Sanskrit, in scripture and guru. Is it arranged of Krishna?
No. No, it's not the arrangement of Krishna. It's your arrangement.
这不是Krishna安排，是您自己安排的。
You have to. I mean, don't worry that you're not able to pronounce the Sanskrit. That's not very big thing.
您不用就把那个梵文发音看得太重，这不是什么了不起的事儿。
But it's good, you studied a bit, you learned a bit, you know, you learned something. You're not perfect, but it's okay.
学一点东西也是好的，就是不完美，就是可以的。 And
yeah.
She said that she prayed to Krishna and Guru that there's only one path to the ultimate truth. She had no other alternative. So she asked your instruction, how can I cultivate the quality of tolerance, concentration, steadiness?
Well, simply by practicing devotional service, all the good qualities will come. You just keep
that.
Yeah, go ahead. We have to be patient, you know? You have to be patient. It's going to take some time, but you're on the path. You know, just like when you take bath, it takes some time to take bath and to get clean. It doesn't happen immediately. You have to be, you know, in the shower, and you have to put the soap on, and you have to wash yourself, scrub yourself, and then rinse all the soap off and everything. It takes time. So the same way, you know, practicing the process of Krishna consciousness is not overnight. It's going to take some time. In anything you learn, it takes time. But you're on the path. We should be happy that we've come on the path. At least now we're on the path, so that's good. We just have to keep going.
现在呢，你已经上路了，已经在这条道路上了。不要图快，已经在道上了，那就是已经好事了。
So you just keep going. Little bit, gradually, you're progressing. You've changed a lot since you became a devotee. You haven't been a devotee very long, but you've come a long way in a short time. You don't see the changes, but I see the change.
您已经在道上了，这里就一点一点的进步，您已经取得了很大的进步了。不是说您自己没觉得。 改变大，但是Guru看到您身上所受的巨大的变化了。The next one, Wenwen.
Wenwen.
与Wenwen, Hare Krishna 顶拜 Guru 和所有奉献者， 请问 Guru Maharaj, Balarama 显身那天， Balaram 显然是那天奉献的是吃以他的西餐了。Krishna Kumar, Balaram 显然是过了吗？
对，过了。
Yeah, she asked that, should we eat Ekadasi meal on the day of the appearance day of Balarama?
Well, some people do that, you know, some people do that. If you want to observe it like that, you can, no harm. Some people do it on the appearance day of the Vishnu Tattva, they only eat Ekadasi. But it's not strict. In ISKCON, they decided that only 3 days had to be Ekadasi. And the 3 days, one is Janmashtami, one is the Gaur Purnima, and the other one is Nrisingha Chaturdasi. And the other festivals, they say, doesn't matter. Because it's difficult in the temples, it's difficult to organize Ekadasi Prasadam.
Vishnu 范畴的这个节日，有的人选择就是吃以他的西餐，但这个不是就是板上钉钉的非常严格的。在 ISKCON 当中就规定有三个节日是需要吃以他的西餐，一个是 Janmashtami Krishna 显年日，第二个是 Gaur Purnima 就在丹念显年日，还有Nrisingha Chaturdasi 就Nrisingha显年日，然后别的就无所谓了。然后因为有的庙宇他们不好安排。
Yeah. So it's. Yeah.
The next one will continue.
Yeah, go ahead.
Draupadi. 明白 Gurudev 深深体会到这个物世界没真正爱。父母认为养育很多年的女儿嫁出去就该得到一笔钱才能心理平衡。Prabhupada 在巴洛基特说，做奉献服务不再欠父母半神的债，那我的父亲天天打电话问我要钱，是我的业报吗？该怎么做好呢？Obeisance to Gurudev, I deeply feel that there's no real love in the genuine love in the material world. The parents think that they have raised up their children, though they have the daughter after marriage.She should, and the parents should get a sum of money back, they will feel peaceful. And Srila Prabhupada said in Bhagavad Gita, if we do a devotional service, we do not owe any debt to parents, to demigods. But why my father, every day, each day, he will call to me and to ask me for money? Is this my karma? What should we do? What should I do?
Yeah, this is your karma. You can see that.
这是你的业报，可以看很明显。
Yeah, sometimes it's like that. It's difficult what to do. No matter how much you give, they're never satisfied. It's never enough.
有时候事情就是这样子的，然后挺难的，那怎么办呢？而且无论你给多少，他们都不满足，就觉得不够，还给。
So you just have to tell them you don't have money. You just tell them you don't have any money. Tell them if I get some money, I'll give you some. But right now, I don't have any money.
您就告诉您爸爸您没钱，您有了钱就给他，但是现在眼下当下是没钱的。
Yeah.
下一是毛毛顶拜敬爱的姑爹，请问牧牛姑娘的爱是最高级的爱，是因为牧牛姑娘的爱最坚信 Krishna 的爱吗？爱每一个人，也赞美每一个人对 Krishna 的爱。Obeisance to the Gurudev. So this question is from Mao Mao. Mao Mao. Because the love of the gopi is the highest love. Is that the reason? Is it because the love of the gopi is the nearest to the love for Krishna, which the love everyone and praise everyone's love for Krishna?
The love of the gopis is considered the highest because they sacrifice everything for Krishna. That they're completely filled with thoughts of Krishna. Whatever they want, whatever they do, is only for the pleasure of Krishna. They can only think of Krishna, and they cannot think of other things. Just like we're hearing this morning. They see the other animals, and they see the other animals as being devotees of Krishna. They see everything in relation to Krishna.
他们的内心装满了Krishna，他们每一个念头都围绕着Krishna，他们每一个举动都是为了Krishna的快乐，他们除了Krishna想的比别的。我们今天早上听到讲课说，他们在赞美温达文的这些动物，都认把他们视为奉献者，而且他们眼中的一切都跟Krishna有关。
They even sacrifice their own chastity for the pleasure of Krishna. So the Krishna said there's no way he could ever repay the love of the gopis.
Krishna 说过, 他没有办法偿还Gopi,木流姑娘对他的爱。
So we are encouraged to learn how to love Krishna from the example of the gopis.
我们被鼓励，我们就得到鼓励，就是把Gopi,木流姑娘对Krishna的爱作为榜样来去学习。
Just as the gopis think of Krishna, we have to learn also to think of Krishna.
Guru and all devotees, as far as those devotees who are accustomed to criticize, how can we help them?
Well, try to praise. Instead of criticizing people, just speak good about people. Try to see people who criticize, they only see the faults. So you have to see the good, and you have to be very positive. They're very negative. They only fault find. But you have to see the good side in everyone. And you have to talk about the good qualities rather than the bad qualities.
Mataji is saying that how can she help this kind of devotee?
I'm telling you, you talk the good things, not talk good things about people instead of bad things.
Some people 应当是努力的去，看别人的光明的一面，要 不要挑剔别人，要总是看好的一面，要正能量，要讲别人的好品质，不要讲别人的坏品质。
Somebody says something bad about someone, you have to say something good about them. They say, oh, that person, they're no good, they never do anything. And you say, no, I know that person, they did a lot. They helped cook, they helped clean. Maybe they didn't give any money, but they didn't have any money. They're very poor, so they couldn't give any money, but they give a lot of time to do service.
就是比如说一个人在跟您说那个人怎么怎么坏，您就得跟他说不这个人特别好，那然后那个他说一个你就得反着说，然后那个人说他你看他又做饭又打扫的，然后那个人比如说这个批评人呢就说你看他也不拿钱，但是你就得说他没钱，但是他花出了很多的时间，付出了很多的时间，你就得反着跟他。
Okay.
Okay. 下一个 Yoga Kisho. 谨记孤入心事，接受 Karma， 容忍学习困境，一起生活，面对考验，远离脱比其他目的。Yoga Kisho do that is repeating your instruction. Should accept our own karma to learn to be tolerant, learn to stay with difficulty and to face the test and to stay far away, shout out other mother.Zaki. Yeah, 酸奶，其他奶是可以喝的，这个才建议喝。Counter scenery. 顶拜咕噜。我单身，带着8岁的孩子，照顾83万的老母亲，欠着10几万的债，想好好修 Krishna 之觉，这么多外债的干扰很难的，但有个佛教徒想帮我还债还欠，还愿意帮我照顾母亲孩子，甚至慢慢帮我灵修 Krishna 之前，他表达跟我的结婚，我能接受吗？ Chandra Sundari said that she paid obeisance to you and she said she's a single, she had a 8 years child and she had her mother who is 83 years old and there areand she had a lot of debts, like hundreds of thousands of RMB. And she wanted to practice Krishna consciousness, but there are so many difficulties. And now there's a Buddhist, male Buddhist. He would like to pay the debt for her.And also take care of the old people and children, child. But he wants to marry her. So she asked, should she accept the marriage? Because there, in the local, there is no local devotee. It's a very difficult situation.
Yeah, but it might be better for her.To accept the marriage, that it can solve all of her problems.
是的，最好您就接受这个求婚，这样您的困难就迎刃而解了。
And you can keep Krishna in your heart.
您就在内心就想，您想着您内心的 Krishna。
嗯哼。
文文，昨天联谊发生了一个不愉快的事儿。俄罗斯奉献者指责中国奉献者派哈勒瓦和豆汤，说奉献者这么做是冒犯。然后还有一个问题，一位奉献者。他要去厨房拿刀子，去客厅切水果。做饭的马大姐说：“今天是俄罗斯奉献做饭，你们中国奉献不要碰。” So yesterday there are some. Yesterday, in the association there are a Russian devotee and Chinese devotee, and the Russian devotee criticized Chinese devotee to distribute Halava and Dao. The Russian devotee said that this is an offense. And another is that one devotee wants to go to the kitchen to fetch knife to cut food in the hall. But the Mataji who's cooking in the kitchen said that it is the turn for Russian devotee to cook. Therefore, your Chinese devotee, you should not touch.
Mm-hmm. So, you have to be sensitive.
He just said that. Yes.
I don't know what is the offense. If you're distributing halva and dal, I don't know how it's an offense. I don't understand. You're giving prasadam. How they can say it's an offense? What does it mean? What is the offense?
那冒犯在哪里呢?
And we didn't want you to take the knife out of the kitchen. Okay, that's fair enough. You have to get your own knife. There's so many other knives. You know, you need to get a knife. You don't take things from the kitchen. It's not good.
Okay. 如果他们不让你们从厨房取刀，你们就自己带刀子。去厨房碰东西也不好，你们应该自己随身带刀子。
Yeah, you got fruit. You want a knife? You get a knife from somewhere. You don't just take the deity's paraphernalia. That's not the way.
因为你们带了水果，然后需要用刀子切水果。你们应该从别的地方取刀子，也不应该去厨房去取神像的这些用具，这样也不好。
Okay.
The next one is from 庞继东顶拜咕噜。我专门为做崇拜养的花顶上一层蜜虫，不知道该如何处理，恳请咕噜明示。Obeisant Guru, and I have a flower, especially for worshipping the deities, for worshipping, but there are a lot of small bugs on top of the plant. So what should I do?
A lot of small insects on top of the plant.
A lot of very small insects that live on the plant.
On the tulsi.
No, not to see, but the flower, only flower.
Uh-huh. Well, you can knock them off, put them back in the garden.
你就把这个花啊，养到花园里，放在花园里。
Just knock the insects, you brush the insects off or sweep them off, put them back into the garden. And you can keep the flower, you can still use the flower, but you don't want the insects. The insects can stay in the garden. Put them in the garden with all the other plants.
如果可能的话，您就把这个花拿到花园里，然后把这个花顶上的这些蜜虫都掸掉，然后呢，这个花还可以继续用来腐败用。Maybe there are too many small bugs.
Too many small bugs.
Yes, a lot of. A covered plant.
Then you have to put the plant back in the garden. You don't use it. You can't offer the bugs to Krishna.
蜜虫太多的时候啊，你就把这个花儿，就是让它回归这个花园里去生长。因为这时候这个花儿你也没办法再供奉了，因为花上也有很多蜜虫。That's all the question, Maharaj.
Really?
Yes.
Okay.
Is this the law to prevent devotee to do service?
What?
No, maybe she's following the Christ's last question about the knives.
Uh-huh. What'd she say?
Maybe this is a behavior to prevent devotee to do service. Is this a kind of a behavior to prevent devotee to do the service?
No, no. But just a small detail.
不是重要的,是细节,小细节。
Yeah, you just have to make sure you're going to do something, you're going to distribute fruits or something, then you've got to organize everything, have everything. You can't just go into the kitchen and take things out of the kitchen while other people are cooking.
就是因为您在做服务要派水果, 那么就需要也是要安排好怎么去派，你不能随随便便的进厨房，就拿出别人需要的这个厨具，别人也需要用的。
Yeah.
Okay, that's all the question.
Don't take these little things so seriously. It's just a small thing, you know. We're all devotees. We have to work together.
不要把这些小事太当真，太较真，我们都是奉献者，我们就需要很好的去合作来做服务。
Yeah. So, we need each other. China devotees need the Russian devotees, Russian devotees need Chinese devotees. We all need each other. We're all together in the service of Krishna.
中国奉献者需要俄罗斯奉献者，俄罗斯奉献者需要中国奉献者，我们彼此都是在一起，共同在做着服务的。Yeah,
if we are supposed to be an international society, so if we have a society and we don't have Russian devotees, it's not good. And if we don't have Chinese devotees, it's not good. We need everyone.
我们这是一个国际 Krishna 直接协会。 不是俄罗斯奉献者协会，也不是仅仅是中国奉献者协会，我们这个是所有人的协会。So,
we are supposed to be the United Nations of the spiritual world.
我们理应是一个灵性世界的联合国。So
we're all together, working together for the service of Krishna.
我们都是在一起，然后我们在一起工作来服务 Krishna.
So please work together happily.
所以请大家兴高采烈的，心情愉快的，一起来合作。Okay,
so 我们感谢 Guru Mani 给我们整体的翻译，我们感谢所有的奉献者聆听。 我们祝福你们，好好念诵，万事如意，Hare Krishna，Srila Prabhupada ki jai。
Hi。 百坤的知音福缘听我们非常非常感谢，圣。